Okay, second on 6-2. I'm just gonna grab 8. I think they're gonna grab that stuff on the east end. You're good in 6, and just let me know when you're done, Mark. You clear PA, correct?
Yes, sir.
All right, grab the crane, stay clear. PA, PA's coming down. Going to come on the east end and grab that stuff.
Welcome back to the Buckeye State Rails. I bet you can tell by the wire tower in the background, we're back at Deshler, Ohio, to be doing some railfanning with my friend Tony, which is Ohio Railfan 1518 Miller, whatever I think. But anyway, I would think we would have some pretty good catches heading our way. We would have an ST catch, and then 1776, and then a Gadget Duo on M560. And I bet you can tell by this chain, this is M350 that's taking the Y from Queensgate Yard in Cincinnati, Ohio, to Clearing Yard in Chicago. That's where it's going to be going for the destination. It had a base duo on this one.
is quarantined.
Yeah, but they go out east, they don't come this way. They go down Florida somewhere. Yeah, they go through Baltimore State sometimes. But the only thing is, there's nowhere to really.
Some coal train come from Newell, Pennsylvania, and I don't know where its destination to, but I would thought this is a coal train. I've never seen a coal train through Deshler. I only have seen coke trains, but this is like a normal coal train, so it's actually pretty cool to see in Deshler because, number one, they don't get it through Deshler as much. Usually they want it down to Marion and stuff. That's usually where they want it through, but I guess Deshler. You know what? I take that back. We get a coal train from Chicago, around there, to Wixom, and then goes up to Saginaw, Michigan. But that usually has been a south power. But this coal train I never seen with the effect power. This ain't the one that comes from Michigan. This one's coming from Newell, Pennsylvania. We'll be right back. I guess I could say that I'm framing because there's two trees, looks like, together. And you can see the tracks. This is not a photo, so I think I could say I can frame. But anyway, this is IO-10 from Chicago or Bedford Park. And it's going all the way over to Port Norwalk in New Jersey. Alright, remember that I said about a Dash 8 duo? This is it, M560. But anyway, I didn't really notice it till it went by me, or my dad recognized it. This is a sister duo of the Dash 8. Okay, this is 7876 that is leading this Dash 8 duo. And the trailing one is 7877. I never seen a sister Dash 8 duo before. And I also never seen a sister one before. so that's kind of cool. But anyway, it had to stop because of a coke train. We didn't really get to see because I was about to be south Deshler till I see this M560 to come. And anyway, we were traveling probably just to get up here. We missed the coke train, and then moments later, this M560 gets a signal to proceed onto the Willis sub with a Dash 8 Duo, heading all the way to Selkirk, New York.
Thank you.
I don't know what symbol this grain train is, but it's a grainer that is heading west on the Garrett and Willard sub. This is my first grain train I ever seen in Deshler. I only see freight, Arlac, and Intermodal, not grain. Well, coal trains I do too. CSXT M352 with the Seaboard 6 system sticker, which is trailing second. M352 originated from Louisville, Kentucky, works Pottersburg in Ohio, and it also goes to Chicago and Illinois. We'll be lucky to see M352 with the Seaboard system. The sticker units and the lettering units are kind of boring. The only units I would agree on is 3194, 1736, and 911.
Thank you.
As you can see, this is a new angle for me. I never been to this spot before. This is in Deshler, of course. You can see the town, right and left. You can also see the well park onto your left as well. And this is kind of a different angle. M209, which comes from Walbridge, Ohio to Louisville, Kentucky. You can also see the tower in the background on the lake, and you can also see the train on the lake. CSX I-191 with a UP and a BNSF as leaders. The leader as the front end is a UP ace, And then the trailing second unit is a BNSF Gevo, elephant style, heading from North Baltimore, heading towards Rochelle and Illinois. And basically, this is elephant style. Alright, B-522, or B-523, that's taking the Y, or the connection, from the Garrett Willard to the Toledo subdivision. This will hit down towards Middletown, Ohio. Steel train is from Detroit to Middletown, like I said, Middletown. The leader is CSXT-799. Which is the front-end leader, and then the mid-DPU is CSXT-3366. This is like a whole steel train for Middletown. Here comes a mixed weight on the Garrett sub. I think this is M369 from somewhere in Pennsylvania or Maryland to Clearing Yard in Chicago, Illinois. A solo's GE in the front and a solo as a mid DPU. This is another CSX intermodal train from Northwest Ohio intermodal terminal at North Baltimore, Ohio towards 59th Street Yard in Chicago, Illinois, via BNSF, and then it'll head over onto the BNSF, and I don't know where it would go there, but this is just free GEs. I would thought there would be a Heritage 1 twin second, but I guess not. I know the camera looks dark, but I'm changing up some settings. You know how some people change up some settings on their DSLR? Well, I'm doing it on my camcorder. But here comes another coke train on the Willard subdivision. Or Garrett subdivision. Whatever I want to name it. Here comes a YN2 leader on this coke train. It looks kind of dark, but I can't help it with that, so I'm changing up the setting. Here's an eastbound on the Garrett Willard subdivision. This is CSX IO-16 that will be coming from Bedford Park to Hamburg, Pennsylvania. It will be working North Baltimore and Carterville, Pennsylvania. This will be having a mid-DPU, which will be special, 1776, but I will shut up. CSX 1776 is basically the spirit of armed forces. I have seen this unit a couple times in my lifetime, and I was lucky that I saw this one at Deshler. Well, I heard about it, but I was basically looking out for the Southern Pacific, which is basically the SP patch, which is leading I-192 heading from Chicago, heading towards North Baltimore, and here comes CSX I-137 with normal GEs. With GEs, it's starting to get boring because around the Toledo area in Fosteria, whatever I go to, I see GEs and AC-44C6Ms on NS, but so CSX is just GEs. Well, there's E&D, but it's basically kind of boring these days. But anyway, I wouldn't record the whole thing on this I-137. But anyway, here comes I-192 with the SP patch. But I'll basically shut up. After getting this Southern Pacific, the FP patch leading this I-192, the day later, it'll be leading I-191 back towards Chicago, unfortunately. I know it's kind of like night, but at least I had my lights with me. But this would probably be the best Saturday in 2023 so far. There might be more. But unfortunately, today's video will be enough here. I'll be seeing you in the Michigan interstate or the Buckeye State Rails.